Thank you for joining us today. I'm Scott Camp. I'm often asked why I believe that there really is a God. You know, the Bible never attempts to prove that God exists. The very first words of the Bible are, "In the beginning, God." And the Bible assumes the existence of God, and it assumes that we are created in the image of God, and that means that we have reason and that we're able to look around us and see that there must be some kind of intelligent designer who made everything that we see. For example, if you think about the universe, the atmosphere, 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, 1% a dozen different trace elements. It's the only atmosphere known to scientists in the entire solar system that is capable of sustaining human and plant and animal life. And then 40 miles up and a fourth of an inch thick, there's something that baffles the scientists. They don't know how it got there, but they know that it provides protection. It envelops the earth and it allows the sun's rays that are needful for human and plant and animal life to come through, but it filters out the deadly rays that would literally fry us up like so much sausage in a skillet. And then the earth is tilted on its axis at 23 degrees, not 22 or not 24. If it were 1 degree off, the gravitational pull of the moon would create tidal waves that would destroy the land surface of the earth and we wouldn't be here. The earth, if it were 1 degree closer to the sun, would burn up like a cinder. 1 degree further from the sun, it would freeze hard like an ice cube. And then they tell us that if the earth were 10% larger or 10% smaller, it could not sustain human life. Now, here's what I'm saying. The earth, it has the perfect protection. It has the perfect atmosphere. It's tilted at the perfect angle. It's the perfect size. How in the world did all that happen without some kind of a creator? In the words of my friend Frank Turek, I just don't have enough faith to be an atheist. If we see an automobile, we know there must have been an engineer. If we see a building, we know there must have been an architect. If we see a watch, we know there must have been a watchmaker. And when we see a universe that's fine-tuned, that has precision and intricacy and detail and design, it tells us there must be a God, a creator. That's why the Bible says the heavens declare the glory of God and the firmament shows forth His handiwork. That's one reason why I believe that there must be a God. Thank you for joining me today. I'm Scott Camp.